buddies, my name is Ryan. So, it came to my mind today that I totally forgot to review this movie. We got one more, so Tom Clancy's The Felt Remorse. The movie's based on a book from Tom Clancy called The Felt Remorse. Full disclosure, I've never read that book. I don't know what it's about. I just saw this movie trailer, really enjoyed that trailer. I said, hey, it's going on Amazon Prime, I'm gonna watch it the day it comes out. I watched it right after I saw The Mitchell vs. the Machine, and I totally forgot that I had to review the movie. I watched it, and then I just went on with my day. I totally forgot that I had to review it, so I'm gonna review it right now, and then right after this, I'll give my review for, Those Who Wish Me Dead, yeah. And, this movie, I think, had a lot of promise, and didn't really live up to any of that promise. I will say this, the first 40 minutes of this movie had them. It did. But, well, first off, I'm getting ahead of myself here. The trailer I thought was fantastic, the first trailer at least. I didn't watch any of the others. The first trailer sold me. I thought it was excellent. The movie, I feel like the trailer really shows the best parts from like the first like 40 minutes of the movie, and even parts of the second trailer. I watched a little bit of the second trailer, but then I stopped. But the first 40 minutes of the movie did have me. So, just really, let me get into what I like about this movie. First off, Michael B. Jordan, he gives a really solid performance. Even when it's kind of like a CG scene, or it's like in a big, bloated action scene with having to like do a lot of physical stuff, he pulls it off. The emotional stuff works, at least with his performance, when he's meant to be like intimidating or threatening. It works whenever he's in the action scene. There's a really cool, like, prison ball in the movie. That's cool. The action scenes are pretty cool. There's a pretty solid, suspenseful scene with a sniper. And, you know, the first 40 minutes of the movie really did have me, because I liked the way it was going. The first, like, 20 minutes did have me. Well, the first, like, 20 minutes, a lot of the emotional stuff comes with those first 20 minutes. That kind of lays the groundwork. And then, when you get to, like, the 40-minute mark, the big, like, overarching plot of the movie kind of, like, gets recognized. And then the movie, the other hour and 10 minutes of the movie happened, and then it kind of just turned into a really generic, like, spy thriller movie with, like, one really long scene with a sniper, one very mediocre chase scene, and just a really cliche ending scene that didn't make me feel anything. Jimmy Bell's also in this movie. He doesn't really do anything. The movie is very strangely edited. There was one scene in the first 40 minutes that is absolutely hilarious, but it's not supposed to be. It made me gut laugh. It made me fall off my bed for how funny it is, and it's not supposed to be funny. Just thinking about it makes me laugh. And the first, like, the opening credits of the movie are very strangely intercut with Michael B. Jordan's military guy going on this mission, and then it's talking about Michael B. Jordan's character, and then once it's like, oh yeah, he's a huge badass, it cuts to black, and you see, like, a title card, cuts to them walking, you see, like, an association with, like, Warner Brothers or something, and just, like, the movie's, like, the opening cuts are very strangely cut in between Michael B. Jordan and his military buddy going on this, like, rescue mission. It's very odd. Last, like, hour and 10 minutes of the movie just became this really very generic, predictable, like, nothing spy movie. And just, it really lost me. This movie really lost me in the final act. So, if I were to give you a rating, I would go with a C. It's very middle of the road for me. I thought it definitely wasted potential. It wasted potential. Had me in the first 40 minutes. Lost me in the last hour and 10 minutes. So, yeah. So, come on, subscribe, and I'll see y'all next time.